All right. Welcome to the interview area. Monterey native Mina Harigae. Mina, how does it feel to be at the U.S. Open here in your hometown?
It feels surreal. I mean, not being home, but, you know, just like all the grandstands, all the buildups. It's such a great atmosphere. I could feel like everything's like buzzing and the whole peninsula is like supporting just everyone being here. I think they're really, really behind it.
You're the course expert out of the group here. What would you tell someone who is playing it for the first time?
I feel like Pebble Beach every day can be totally different. It could be beautiful and sunny, and you could be fogged in the next day, or even honestly the next like 20 minutes you could be fogged in. So it's like almost like a brand new experience every single round or even every single hole. So I think you just have to really just enjoy it out there.
You knew coming out of your runner-up finish last year, coming here to Pebble, that there was going to be some more outside-the-ropes activities for you. I know you've done a ton of interviews. You've had a crew following you. Just talk about what that's been like.
It's been so amazing after last year. You know, there's so much – a lot of people want to come and support me, be part of Team Mina. I mean, not only the benefits of, obviously, that big check last year, but I think it's really awesome that I have more supporters. I have a great big contract with pros. They're supporting me. They're on my team. You know, PX, she's always been by my side. Amex this week, supporting for small businesses. Takara Sushi is my parents' restaurant, so got a really cool deal with them. But yeah, you know, this is amazing.
Speaking of deals, I know you're doing something cool with Malvin in your high school. Can you explain that?
Yep, we had a really great collaboration event last week. Last night. We did. It was to help raise funds, you know, for my alma mater, Stevenson School. Got a cool logo. My husband actually designed the cool little logo with a pirate eye patch, and it turned out really great. It's beautiful. Forest green, which, you know, we're surrounded by here, and it was just a really cool event, and I saw a lot of people who I haven't seen in a while, new friends, old friends, and, you know, it was so much support for women's golf, and it's really cool to see Malvin Golf going in that direction as well, and they're launching a women's line Thursday, actually, so that's really cool to see.
We've got one from the WebEx here. You know this course well, but how has it looked different for U.S. Open, not just the grandstands, but the golf course this week?
It was actually funny, like in the practice round last couple of days, it's actually easier to pick targets because there's more, you know, TV towers, grandstands, but the rough is gnarly. You can get really bad lies out of there. Fairways are rolling great, greens are, you know, getting firmer by the day, and I mean, it's not a resort golf course anymore. This is championship golf.
What's your favorite hole out here?
It's such a basic answer, but I love 7. It's so fun. It's short. It's beautiful. And you could just have a lot of fun on that hole.
One more here from the WebEx. The last few majors have been won by women 25 and younger. So can you just speak to kind of the moment in women's golf and the future for it?
I think women's golf is in a great place. There's so many young up-and-coming golfers, superstars, obviously Rose Zhang. I think it's in really good hands. Everyone's really good coming out of college, coming, you know, even before college, turning pro right away. But it's really cool to see, and I'm really happy to be a part of that growth and in that journey of women's golf. And, you know, this is my 14th year out here, and just to still be out here and be a part of the whole journey, I think it's really cool.
Yeah, question right here.
Yeah, Mina, Jonathan Linden was KAZU out of Marina. Can you talk about, you know, when I talked with you last time, you said you've done this course 50 plus times at least, something like to that extent. Can you talk about, expand more about how this time will be different for you?
Obviously, it'll be different this time because, I mean, there's way bigger crowds and, you know, hopefully a lot of support. But, I mean, I think just it's a historic moment in women's golf and just golf in general. We're here at Pebble Beach, an iconic spot, where so much history has been made. So in that aspect, I think it's just a monumental part of history that's happening here. So, I mean, you could just feel it in the atmosphere. So I think in that aspect, it's different. And obviously course conditions are gonna be championship major, top of the top course conditions. So, yeah, I think those are probably it.
Could you talk more about, so it sounds like you did something with a local school. What are some of the local people you'll be able to see since you're back in town for the tournament?
So actually yesterday, I saw old teachers, middle school teachers, high school teachers, even my third grade teacher came out to see me yesterday. So that it was so cool just to see everyone from my past come out and support me. And it's just, it's cool to have the community behind you.
Have any of the players asked you much about the golf course?
No, not really. I don't think a lot of players know that I'm actually from here, but you know, my friends, actually, you know what? The players have asked me more about my parents' restaurant than the golf course itself, actually.
Any other questions? Awesome. Thanks, Mina, for your time.
Thank you.